evening. Welcome to Jaffam Podcast Live Let's Plays. This is the second game in the series of Nintendo games that I own, called 1942. 1942 was a 1986 shooter that was released by Capcom Micronics. It has 1 to 2 players and is relatively easy to find if you're looking for the NES game. Hold on, stand by 1 second while I tweet out. Happening now. At www.twitch.tv. Just a few more minutes. And I will hashtag retro gaming. Yeah, I might as well throw video games on there too. Tweet. And then all right, so let's get started. So basically what I'm doing, or what I'm trying to do, is play through each of my Nintendo games that I own, starting at the very beginning, because I have a lot and I don't really know all the games all that well. So I have about 630 games, and this is number 2 on the list. So let's get started. All right, here we go. All right. Wow, sound is terrible. Take part of my headphones off here, because this is just blowing my ears out. So the graphics are pretty good. It's a little sluggish. Whoa, that was close. See. I guess you just try not to get killed here. Wow. There's no like melody or anything to the music. It's just awful. You can tell it's an early shooter because you have to like mash the buttons in order to make them shoot. You can't just hold it down, which was a nice thing added to shooters later in time. Power up. Yes. Now I got the barrage of bullets in front of me. 1942. I remember seeing this game in the stores and not really wanting anything to do with it. And I could swear to you, I've probably played this once since I've bought it. Alright, here we go. We're coming up on something. What am I doing here? Oh, okay. Landing on the aircraft carrier. Wow, there's 32 stages. That is insane. Man, the power-ups are definitely needed, I can tell you that much. What, I get an extra life? Man, the controls are so sluggish. Ah, damn it. Wonder where it spits you out when you're dead. There's no real way of telling because you're in the middle of this blue sort of crusty looking texture. God, the sound is so bad. I only have my, half a headphone on. Just because I just don't want to listen to it. Whoa, that was close. Whoa, this thing is shooting at me now? And how is it moving like that? That's not aerodynamically possible, man. Holy shit! How in God's name did I survive that? Alright, my thumb is cramping because I can't hold the button down. Wow, that was only the second level. That's pretty intense. Alright, here we go again. So, I don't know what number designates an extra life. Speaking of extra life, we will be having a retro gaming marathon this year. And we are taking donations for Boston Children's Hospital. Oh, that was cool. Please consider donating. For more information, go to justafewmoreminutes.com. 100% of your donations go directly to the hospital. That will be happening on November 12th. Oh, come on! That is intense. Beep, 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 beep. Oh, I couldn't do anything there. Shooting down 351 percentage 72. Game over. I wonder if there's a continue. Let me see real quick. 1942 NES continue. Looks like the only thing there is for the Game Genie. Damn it. Please, Captain Skyhook. Captain Skyhawk. Hello, Jeff. Hello, Bentle Giant. How are you guys doing? Jeff, I hope you're feeling better. Yes, I am going through all the games alphabetically. So, I'm gonna play this again. There's a continue. Duh. Right on my damn screen. Haha. These little green guys are bastards, man. Yes, Jeff, we all hope you're feeling better. Look forward to the Retro Gaming Expo this coming weekend. Right, third stage. I wonder if there's much variation to the intensity of the game. Because this is a pretty early shooter. I mean, I feel like I don't want to speak too soon, but it feels as though there's not much more they can throw at me. Because, they can only have so many sprites on the screen at one time. And I can't imagine there's a lot of variations in the game of characters. Characters being the little planes. Oh, damn it! I didn't see that guy. So in Pat Contry's book, The Ultimate Guide to the NES Library, he wrote, "It's interesting how Capcom developed a game where you're a U.S. fighter," the Capcom being a Japanese company, "how you're a U.S. fighter taking down Japanese warplanes." It's an interesting point. We gotta get Meme Hub working. That sounds like that'd be fun. I never heard of Meme Hub. What is it? Yeah, I like this. I like this power up. Just mows everything down. Oh man. It's hard to see those green guys against that green background. They are some smart motherfuckers, those fucking developers. That's how they do it. What do these do? Ah, you prick. Wow, that'd be pretty fucking cool. It only works with ROMs, I'm assuming. Ah, fuck off. Ah, yes. I love bullet hell. Good times. Man. Contrast in this game is just fucking mwah. It's like oh, there's nothing I can do there. Still at 72%. Wonder how many continues I have before they pull the plug on me. So, I think this is level 4. Fuck off. This is... Come on, aircraft carrier, where are you? My thumb's getting tired again. There you are, you beautiful bastard. Whew. I think. I'm surprised, this being such an early Nintendo game, I'm surprised there's, surprised I haven't experienced any slowdown. What was my power up there? Got a power up, but it didn't do anything. What the hell was that? Looks like I got another life. Ah. Come on, I gotta be getting close to the damn aircraft carrier by now. Ah. Ah! That was bad. Oh, I dropped 71%. That's no good. Oh, I hit start instead of continue. God damn it. Alright. There's no like bosses or anything in here, it's just going on patrols, I guess. Let's see how long I can keep my plow here. It's all generally the same gameplay. Between one level to the next, I mean, maybe there's like speed or intensity been amped up a little bit, but for the most part, I can't really tell. So I'm actually gonna play through this as long as I don't forget my, as long as my continues don't run out. Once my continues run out, then I'll, or I do something stupid like hit start instead of continue. Then I'll throw in 1943 in so we can see the difference. Especially after listening and watching this for so long. There we go. Almost a flawless first level. I am very Oh, I didn't know that guy shot at me. Son of a bitch. I was just gonna say, I am very surprised that this game actually plays as smooth as it does, it being one of the first fucking Nintendo games to come out. Like, I can imagine going from Atari to this and being blown away. I mean, of course there's far superior shooters on the platform. Trying to think of a couple of them. I know Gunknack is one of them. That is a game I don't have, because it is very expensive. But it is claimed to be one of the best shooters in the system. I actually really enjoyed Dragon Spirit when I was a kid. I had a copy of that. That was a shooter. And yes, Jeff, I'll give Legendary Wings its props for being a good shooter. Even though I hated it because it wasn't a shooter to me. Or I wasn't expecting a shooter when I bought it. But in hindsight, it was a good shooter. Man, I couldn't imagine if this was a real battle going on. the amount of like planes and shit, all the parts sinking in the ocean and destroying the environment. Thanks, Ben. Take it easy, brother. Damn. Hey, 79%. That's better. Oh. Well, that's pretty cool. The other button actually does like a loop-de-loop if I get in trouble. Wow, that was... They didn't waste any time kicking my ass that time. It is nice having these two little planes by my side. That's some serious... firepower right there. What happened? No, I've been just concentrating on shooting. Yes, that's an idiot move, right? Imagine that'd come in handy when, in those tight spots that you can't get out of. Like now. Yeah, that's gonna come in handy. I'm an idiot for not trying it sooner. Percent. I really wish they spent just a little more time on the fucking soundtrack, though. I mean, I don't think that's too much to ask. Barely fucking got out of that one. Sent a house at me just then. Ah. Going for that percentage. Oh, that didn't work out for me at all. Oh, man. Come on, damn it. Where's this aircraft carrier? Ah, you prick. %75%. Getting there. Alright, I think this was the level I was at last time when I made that stupid mistake of not continuing. I have a feeling I'm going to be spamming that soon. Damn. Ah, I just hit the loop-de-loop button too, damn it. Alright, here's the water. That's a good sign. Come on. Oh, they're shooting two bullets now, little fuckers. Yeah, I just noticed that. Oh, you bastard. At least it started me right where I was at. Wow. Wow, they're sending like entire foot. Oh, what could I have done there? Thing shot me right in the face at point blank range. And those things are pains in my ass. Come on. Holy shit. Come on, explode already. Yes. So the less loops I use, the more points I get towards a one-up. Man, they're already sending guys from the bottom. Thank you, Jeffrey. What the hell hit me? Okay, I can continue. I wonder if you have unlimited continues in this game. Man, this is like fucking onslaught. Come on, you bastards. What am I fighting here? Uh-oh, a boss. A boss plane. Holy shit. Well, that didn't last very long. That was crazy. How the hell was I supposed to fight that thing? Let's see what happens when I get there again. Gonna unleash some fury here. Keep moving around. Oh man. That's the cheapest thing in the world, man. It's like a silly little sprite that it's just one sprite in the middle of the screen that just moves around. Like the level just scrolls. Yeah, I'll loop this time. Yeah, your mother. I can't get over there. Yes. That's one huge explosion. Whoa, you get 200,000 points for that? And you land the carrier. -93% on that time. Right, here we go. Yeah, I got 50,000. I didn't get an extra life. What the hell? Eat it, Japan. Eat shit, Japan. Oh, God. Alright, plowed through that level. There we go. The firepower. Come on, getting close. Don't fuck it up now. Nice. Pete is a one-man tsunami. Fear him. Oh, cool. I get to keep my power-ups. gotta get those points so I could get more lives, motherfucker. Ah, shit. See, because I need them. Back to this little pea shooter piece of shit. $2,000 for that. That's pretty sweet. Uh-oh. Am I fighting another boss? There's a whole lot of nothing going on there for a second. Whoa! A lot of those fucking green jet things. Oh, I just hit the loop-de-loop button. Getting better at the percentage thing. Have a bunch of continues, but tell you what. Let's throw in 1943 for perspective and see how much better this one is. So this one was released almost 2 years later, in October 1988. Released, developed by Capcom, 1943, and is also very, very relatively easy to find. But I just want a taste of this. I wanna see what the, I wanna see what the difference is before I call it a night. So here we go. Now I could already tell that there's title music, so that's already pretty awesome. There's a password. There's a story. 1943, our main fleet and the enemy's mobile unit have begun an intense battle of the coast, off the coast of Valhalla Island. Alright, let's do this. Oh, wait a minute. So you can actually level up your plane. That's pretty cool. That's a big difference. I'm gonna give myself some offensive power. Some defensive power. Energy level, special weapon time limit. Let's add it to the special weapon time limit. Wow, the sound is already, like, so much better. Oh, and it's so much smoother. Holy crap. Oh, and I could charge up my special weapon. This is interesting. I'm, like, shooting this, the power up, and it's changing. Wow, I can't believe how much smoother this is. Only 2 years makes a huge fucking difference. Whoa! Talk about empowerment to the player. Tremendous difference. Whoa, that was my special. Did you see that? That was fucking awesome. Hidden items. Visual contact with surface forces confirmed. Commencing attack. Oh wow, so you actually go in, dive down, and like destroy things. Feels a hell of a lot more epic than the than 1942, that's for damn sure. Alright, what am I up against here? Oh, I'm running out of energy. Crap. How many guns are on you, you fucking ship? Ah, damn it. Well, there's your taste of 1943 for tomorrow. Or, not tomorrow, the next time I play. I'd like it to be tomorrow, but I can't play tomorrow night because I teach. So, anyway, thank you for hanging out with me, and thank you for checking out 1942. It was pretty awesome, I gotta say, although pale in comparison to 1943. Like, just, I'm excited about my next stream because of playing 1943. 1942 was fun as it was once I got used to the controls and the stickiness of the character, the clunkiness. But 1942, I don't know if I'd recommend it as far as playing goes. I think 1943 is much better. But just from that little bit of playing. But all right, guys, take care. See you soon. Thanks for hanging out.